In this tutorial, we shall limit ourselves with the law and constructing an illustrative table. In the real world, a consumer consumes a number of goods with his limited income. Law of equi-marginal utility tells us how he allocates his limited income among these goods. The law is, when a consumer consumes more than one good with his limited income, he will consume them in such a way that he gets the same marginal utility from the last unit of money spent on each of these goods, so that his total utility is maximum. The points to understand about this law are: consumer's income is limited. He allocates his entire income on several goods. His aim is to maximize his total utility. To achieve this, he equates the marginal utility of the last unit of money spent on these goods. Let us make our analysis simple by assuming the consumer is consuming two goods, say good X and good Y. His income or money at his disposal is 50 rupees. The price of good X is 10 rupees. The price of good Y is 5 rupees. In the consumption of goods, law of diminishing marginal utility operates. Let me first present the utility schedule for good X and good Y. As the consumer consumes more and more units of good X, its marginal utility diminishes. Similarly, the marginal utility of good Y is also diminishing with additional consumption. This is in accordance with the law of diminishing marginal utility. The next step is, we have to see what is marginal utility of the last unit of money. It is very essential to know this to understand the law. In plain language, it means marginal utility divided by price. Price can otherwise be understood as number of units of money. It is also known as ratio of marginal utility to price or proportion of marginal utility to price. Its actual interpretation is the marginal utility of one unit of money. We shall use this to complete the table. When the consumer consumes the first unit of good X, its marginal utility is 90 units. Its price is 10 rupees. Marginal utility is to be divided by its price to find MUX by PX. 90 divided by 10, 9 units. Now, the consumer consumes the first unit of good Y. Its marginal utility is 50 units. Its price is 5 rupees. In its case, the marginal utility of the last unit of money is MUY by PY, that is 50 by 5, 10 units. In the same way, we can complete the table. This is the table we are going to use in consumer's equilibrium. We shall meet again in part 2.